Hey, how you doing? Andy with you for another song lesson. Today we're taking a look at the classic Cats in the Cradle, and I'm making a bit of a mix-up version of this between the Harry Chapin original version and the Ugly Kid Joe. I play this song for acoustic solo gigs, so that's sort of what I'm going to show you. So I'm going to start off by just getting you going with the chords, but something that you do want to get first is the chord chart that I've got for you. So click the link below and then you can get that printed out, and then you won't have to come back and watch the lesson again and again when you if you forget anything like that. So I'll hit pause for you right now. Take about a minute to go and get it, and then we'll kick in from there. Okay, so you've got your chart there all printed out, ready to go. Let's dig in. The first thing we want to look at is what chords we've got. So the chords in this song are E, G, A, D, and a bit of C. There's one more sneaking in later, but we'll look at that afterwards. So I'm going to assume that you've got those chords going on already. They're pretty common chords. If you have any difficulties with them, once again, I'm going to give you a link to a handy resource to help you out with your chords if you do have any troubles with those. So I'll assume you've got those sorted. Let's dig in. Okay, the verse to start with, I'll play it through and then I'll break it down for you. Here we go. 3, 4. So there's our verse. Let's have a look at what we've got there. First of all, our strumming pattern is down, 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 up, down, 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 up. And within that, there's some miss strokes. Down, miss, down, down, up, down, miss, down, down, up. Try that on an E chord to start with. 3, 4. Down, miss, down, down, up. Great. If you've got that going, then you can apply it to the chords from there. So I'm going to roll through those chords really slowly and call them out as we go. 3, 4, E, G, A, E. Repeat it all. E, G, A, E, D, G, E, G, and E for a whole bar. 2, 3, 4. Great, there is our verse sorted out. On from there, we then look at our chorus section, which is mostly the same chords, just the order is changed around to those chords. So if you've got your verse, the chorus shouldn't give you too much trouble either. So we'll do the same thing. I'll call them out for you and we'll go from there. And of course, if you've got your chart, you can follow through. You don't have to listen to me calling out the chords as well. So, 3, 4, E, D, G, A, E, D, G, E, G, E. Fantastic. So you've got your verse, you've got your chorus, then you're just essentially repeating the same thing for the second verse and chorus. Now you notice I haven't put the intro in because I'm going to make that a separate lesson, just so you can focus on the main parts of the song, and then you can get all your little extra frills and that sort of thing as a separate lesson. So I'll provide a link for that when that is done. So the only other section we've got left there is the bridge section. Let's have a look what we've got going on there. We have C, D, and then we've got the one additional chord that I mentioned earlier, which is a B. And the way that we're going to do this, it's kind of like a power chord. We're going to play first finger on the second fret A string, we've got third finger on the fourth fret D string, and the fourth finger is on the fourth fret G string. And then we're going to let the open B and E ring out underneath that. So it's kind of like a glorified power chord. So that's the one we're going to use there. And then we've got E for a full bar. So I'll play through that and then we'll do a little slower. 3, 4. So working through that slow, we've got C for two beats, one, two, and a D, B, E. Then the same thing the second time. So what you'll notice is between that D and the B, you're just getting single strums. Rather than keeping all that strumming going on. So you put all that together, there you have the main parts of the song, the strumming, the chords to get you through. You can then throw in the picking intro and other variations from there. So check out my other lesson for the intro. And if you have no hassles with what we've got there and you want to add a few little embellishments on, I have a separate lesson for that one. And you can check out how to add some suspended chords, add some picking in, all that sort of thing. So I'll play through with a few of those extra bits so you can see what I'm referring to. So there it is with a few little embellishment, as I said, suspended chords and that sort of thing, a few little slash chords and that sort of additional stuff. So if you want to learn those bits, click the link for that and you can check that out there. So hope you've enjoyed that. Hope that gave you some good insight how to get it going on a nice, easy level. And if you haven't already got the printout chart, grab that with the link below and that will definitely help you out from there. So look forward to catching you for another lesson really, really soon. Check out the Nail Guitar channel to learn more songs. And check out my other channels for heaps of free guitar training videos. If you're on Facebook or Twitter, you can catch me there also.